look how many foreigners there are. The foreigners are everywhere, aren't they? The foreigners and the drama. That was one of the things that kind of, you know, has been on my radar a little bit. I mean, it's just like one theater performance after another, and drama-getty, you know.
Basically, as an expat coming to the Philippines from Western countries, there's a big community of expats out here. And what you would think when you come over here is you got to watch out for Filipinos, you know, you're out of your element.
There are despicable people out there.
What I've noticed, really what's going to be a problem is other expats.
Look how many foreigners there are. The foreigners are everywhere, aren't they? The foreigners and the drama.
That's the type of people that we're dealing with here.
I mentioned in my last video that I was going to take a little time off for the holidays, and I did just that. I managed to watch more YouTube videos than what I'm used to, and I'm simply amazed at how many guys have jumped into the vlogging scene in the Philippines. It's hard to count them all. And many of them are contributing more drama than they do fanfare. This video in no way attempts to identify or belittle any of them. It only seeks to point out the level of absurdity that the level of vlogging has reached in the Philippines. Be it entertaining to some or a complete waste of time for others, that can only be determined by the viewer. My take on vlogging has always been about inspiring others and the sharing of information that helps to inform people. Living in this part of the world is not everyone's cup of tea, and producing good educational content should be the focus for all bloggers, in my opinion.
I needed information and I was going crazy.
But in the grand scheme of things, it's drama that gets the views, and reputation of bloggers is degraded.
It's kind of like end of an era.
The drama in Dumaguete has apparently reached epidemic levels.
It seems really toxic over there.
Seems really toxic over there.
Maybe someone will need to make a vaccine for that.
I've just been watching YouTube, man. I've been watching all these dudes, you know, faking chronic injury or faking chronic illness so they can get a support on their channels. I mean,
maybe someone will need to make a vaccine for that. I was a bit surprised to see that some more established vloggers have joined the drama surfing circuit.
Community needs to know that these are not people that build up others.
Adding a dash of controversy to their content, hoping to catch a wave. But I suppose when the fish are hungry, the stinkier the bait, the more fish you attract.
We'll see what happens. And he rolls it running away.
I am not running from anything.
I'm just here to bring it, Jim. Just here to put it out there.
Are you kidding me?
I have no problem with the guy. I mean,
you're nothing but a piece.
I apologize for actually calling him out without even getting the facts straight. You know, everybody's going to be civil. Everybody's going to talk in a civil manner.
Took one punch at me and I took 55 and hammered them into the ground and embarrassed them heavily.
I'm kind of trying to sway away from the, what do you call it? The drama a little bit and move on to, like, there might be some breaking news today. Bloggers giving bullshit advice.
Holy shit.
There's a lot of YouTubers there.
So if there is one city in the Philippines that's getting a lot of negative attention, it is Dumaguete. People are calling it Dramaguete.
People are running out of content. A lot of people are talking. Some smack. We all like each other. There's nobody who really hates a YouTuber in the Philippines.
You're nothing but a piece of
is it just people talking smack and there's no substance, or is there a little bit of substance?
More no substance.
There are guys that have this insatiable drive to discover the Philippines, and it has become unfortunate that those who turn to YouTube looking for valid and collective information about the Philippines now have to sort through all the bullshit to find good guidance.
House, bro.
Or whatever it is they're looking for. Many info seekers unfortunately wind up being misguided and they develop an unfounded perspective, and that can't be helpful if and when they ever reach these shores.
Now I have people in the comments threatening to pull up on me. As you can see from this video you're looking at, I am not hiding.
I am not running from anything.
As a collective, vloggers should hold themselves to a higher set of standards. They should take pride in the content they produce. Information, after all, is what the viewer is seeking, so why not provide them with the best, most accurate information possible? It's not my place here to recommend any one vlogger over another. Most times a vlog's popularity is personality driven. But the standard that any info seeker should strive for is accuracy. Not all vloggers are created equal, and those who just fell off the proverbial turnip truck have no real experience with living in the Philippines.
It is my 1 year anniversary.
Nor do they have a solid understanding of the culture.
Yeah, I've been in the Philippines 1 year now, man.
While they may provide an interesting newbie perspective, which can be entertaining, one should never formulate life-changing decisions based upon such a virgin perspective. And to do so would be, well, a tad bit foolish. I guessed what surprised me the most about watching a few of these vlogs was the number of seasoned expat vloggers who have all come full circle and now fuel the drama engine.
A few months ago, there was a, shall we say, saga, a troll, for lack of a better word. And he makes videos talking crap about basically anybody that has more subscribers than he does. And there's not necessarily anything wrong with that. I mean, the National Enquirer is something that has been around for quite some time.
You're nothing but a piece of
people love gossip and people love drama.
Stop harassing my family! Leave my family alone!
As with many of the talking head bloggers, originality and good content have gone the way of the blogger. Remember those guys? There just isn't anything of substance left to talk about.
No substance.
That hasn't been discussed already.
Who pissed who off? Who made who angry? Who decided to go after who?
I'm not gonna really say much about the guy.
You gotta be kidding me.
Andy, where did all this start? The issue you have with Tim having an issue with you. Like, where did this begin?
Philippine expat vloggers really blows my mind.
Oh, look, it's Jordan Melby there. You know Jordan Melby is so f***ing ugly. The guy's making chicken coops in the U.S.
Always.
Called Good Morning Philippines, Rumble in the Jungle.
The continuing drama, I call it the drama because it tends to feed the hungry bloggers.
And without any creativity, some talking heads could already be on their way out, amounting to another extinction-level event, like the expat blogger. Some of them should simply climb down off the hay wagon already. It's getting rather crowded.
Really blows my mind. Blows my mind. Blows my mind.
You know what? We don't normally say negative things about people.
Are you kidding me?
However, I have to bring up, I'm not bashing people.
I was watching a video this morning, and I really don't like talking about other people. And you know me by now, okay? I don't give a shit. Why? I have no idea. It's because it's just not my style.
It blows my mind.
Philly in the Philippines.
I'm just here to bring it, Jim.
He was good for his time.
Always.
Being successful does not make you an idiot.
You're kidding me.
It blows my mind.
At this point in the video, I will say that my intention was to never delve into the expat performing arts. But like a few others, some of us might feel the need to shine some light on all the nonsense, not as clickbait or for more exposure, but to point out the obvious to anyone who originally came to YouTube looking for inspiration and good intel to help guide them.
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
It blows my mind.
Or Carefree Chris, he's all alone. He got kicked out of Dumaguete from the Dumaguete Mafia.
On the dairy farm, the cream always rises to the top. And in the vlogging world, the few bad apples, that idiom applies. My question to those viewers hooked on watching any of these swanky drama doers would be this. Why? Maybe you have been distracted away from your original intended research. If so, you should focus more on those video creators that put in the time and the real effort to bring you the best content possible. Those who inspire, inform, entertain, they can actually help you with the information you're looking for. You would be better off and better informed in the long run and you will not waste your valuable time on a bunch of nothingness. Of course, that's if you have nothing better to do with your time. I guess I can end my little diatribe here with saying that this is an opportunity for a few good YouTubers to rise above it all.
You've got to be kidding me.
And start promoting the good guys instead of the bad apples for a change. Who are the good guys? Well, that's not for me to decide here, but in a nutshell, they are the more seasoned and better informed expats who can provide you with some clarity, good intel, and direction. And they don't promote the drama. A few good vloggers will definitely put the dreamers back on track.
I don't really try to get into the relationship as much as some of the other vloggers out there do. We do talk about it on occasion. I'm not putting down these guys by any means. I'm just stating the reality of it. And I'm not knocking them, so don't get me wrong on that.
You're nothing but a piece of
I'm not saying that. Trust me.
Boy, the Doomageddon Mafia is sure getting all... They think they can't be touched or something. Something's going on in Doomageddon. They're driving out all the YouTubers. Anyway...
It blows my mind.
Thank you so much for watching this video. We do hope you enjoyed it. Please help us out by mashing that like button, and don't forget to subscribe and ring that notification bell. Also, a huge thanks to all our Patreons, who without your support, this channel would not be possible. For real-time updates, follow us on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, and X. And always remember, never give up on a dream. And we'll see you next time.